Hey everyone, it's Emily, and today we're doing an apartment build, which I feel like I haven't done in forever. I used to have part of my schedule, I'd always do apartments on Saturdays, and I haven't done one in, I think, at least 3 weeks. I don't know, it's been a while, but I'm excited about this one because I just wanted to do a cute little apartment today, and I haven't been in the mood for apartments, so I haven't, like, forced myself to do them or anything, but yeah, I just felt like doing one, so I was like, let me take advantage of this and maybe kind of get back to schedule. I don't know, we'll see. But basically, I have a couple videos other than this one that are kind of recorded and ready to go. I just have to do the voiceover and stuff, but two of them have the exact same color scheme on the outside, and I didn't realize that until I was editing the thumbnails for them, and I was like, oh, these are like the same build. Well, not the same build, because one of them's a house and one of them's a restaurant, but they have the same color scheme, so we're gonna try to split those up a little bit instead of putting them right next to each other. So that's what this is, and I really like this apartment. I like how it turned out. It actually didn't take me that long, because usually I can spend like an hour and a half on an apartment, which is probably super ridiculous to some people, because I know some people can do like mansions in that time or less, and it takes me that long to do an apartment, but this one took me 50 minutes, so look at me go, I am getting faster, I don't know. But this is a pretty cute apartment. I made it very neutral, and at first I was kind of thinking like it was Scandinavian inspired, but I didn't really look up what exactly that is. Just from what I know about design stuff, I'm pretty sure it's a lot of white and black and wood tones, so I feel like I kind of did that, but I'm also not going to call it like Scandinavian or anything because I don't really know how well I accomplished that part of it, but that's kind of what I was inspired by. And I was thinking this was an apartment for a single parent. I was specifically thinking like a single dad and then their little toddler who's about to become a child. So I put lots of, well, not lots of, there's some remnants of kids things in this apartment, basically like the little backpack in the living room. They have a nice big couch. They have, actually, considering only two people live here, they have a very big living room, and they have a pretty big dining table too. Their kitchen is tiny, but that's okay. This is an apartment that I think originally is Penny Pizzazz's apartment, I want to say, but I think that it comes as like a not even one bedroom. It's like a studio apartment with just the bathroom is a separate room, but everything else is one room. I think that's how this apartment normally looks, but I crammed a lot of stuff in here, I think. And oh, I wanted the desk to be like a workstation for the parent with a really nice computer, but it also is like decorated kind of like it's the kid's desk, so it has the little kid chair that came with, I think, my first pet stuff. I really like the wood tone of that chair. I think that it looks really nice. And then I also wanted to put the little robot lamp up there because I thought it was cute, and I feel like I actually do use it a lot, but I was gonna say I haven't used it in a while. I don't know, it just seemed like the perfect little lamp to go up there. And this is my new favorite table in the whole game because it has the wood top and then the white legs, and I think it looks so good, but it was way too big for that little cubby thing where I put their table. So I used a table from Parenthood that's like the same concept as the other one, but yeah, I don't know, I like that table a lot. The other one, this one's okay, it's like a knockoff version of the other table that I like but is too big, so there's that. But anyway, how are you guys doing? I'm doing great. My boyfriend is actually here right now, and I feel kind of weird with him sitting in the other room, and I'm just in here recording, and I close the door, and he's reading something, so I don't even know if he's listening to me, but he might be, so I guess I'll find out after this. But I don't know, it makes me feel weird that someone might be listening to me. And I do live with my parents right now, so I mean, theoretically, they could be listening to me anytime, but I just don't think about that, and I feel like they're probably too busy doing other stuff in the house. They probably don't care what I'm saying that much, so I just think about it like that, and then I'm fine, but I don't know what he's doing or how much he can hear me, but I guess, yeah, like I said, I'll find out in a minute, because this is almost over, and this is a really short build, because like I said, I got it done pretty fast. But that's okay. Actually, did I even say that in this voiceover? I have no idea, because I started this, I got like 2 minutes in, and then I realized that part of my recording got messed up, because I thought that I fixed my recording issues that I talked about once this past week, but I don't think that I have. I think that I need to play around with OBS stuff, because it isn't working for me. But anyway, it's fine. I didn't have to cut out too much this time, so that's okay. What's exciting? I don't know. I was gonna say, do I have anything going on? Oh, I don't know if I mentioned this in a video, but I know that I tweeted about it. But last weekend, I just randomly decided I wanted a Fitbit, and I was looking on their website, and I've been wanting a smartwatch for a while because I used to have one, and then it broke and the company went out of business, so I couldn't get a new one. But anyway, I was like looking at Fitbits, and I realized that they had like a smartwatch type of Fitbit, and I was like, ooh, I want this. And I just kind of bought it on a whim because now that I have a job, I have actual money. Whereas before, I would just be like, oh, let me add it to my list. Maybe I'll ask for it for something. Maybe I'll think of something else I want more and not. But anyway, I just kind of bought it and it was on back order. So I was like, okay, this isn't even real for like a week or two, right? Because since it's on back order, they hadn't charged me for it yet. So I was like, oh yeah, it's not real. I didn't really buy it. And then all of a sudden my order started processing. So the charge went through and I was like, oh, I did that. That's something that I did this weekend or that I did like whatever day that I did it. I was like, oh, that really happened. But anyway, it's coming on Tuesday and I'm really excited about it. Because I find myself like, now that I'm thinking about like, oh, I have a watch on the way, I like want there to be a watch on my wrist now, even though I don't have it yet, but it's fine. I'm really excited. But anyway, the build's pretty much over. I had a lot of fun playing around with these stupid hamster wall decals because I've only done that once before and I ended up cutting it out because I did it in the house that I built for my collab with Avalyn Sims. And she didn't do anything I did. But I decided that like putting all the wall decals was really tedious and I would have had to cut out other cool furnishing things that I did in the collab. So I decided to cut that out of that one, but it's in this one because it's a really small apartment. But anyway, we're on the screenshots now. I hope you guys enjoyed it. This was a very all over the place video, so sorry about that, but I hope you don't mind. Anyway, I hope you're having a great day and thanks for watching. Bye.